I was just watching the news, and there was a sort of a story about Curtis McGrath, the athlete that was participating in the Commonwealth Games. I don't know really the full story, but it raises again the concerns of this country's neglect in understanding the needs of those with challenges and disabilities. Apparently, there was some issue with him having to take his prosthetic leg off. You know, I really would have thought that if there was an awareness that if there are people with challenges that are participating in such events, that the necessary provisions and inclusions are made within the participation anyhow. You know, there would have been some way of actually being able to accommodate the situation. I think that this country really fails mightily with disability inclusion. A lot of buildings are still not really up to standard, and a lot of supports and services around the country are not up to standard. And it's just the she'll be right made attitude. Oh, we're just near enough, it's good enough, we'll just do what we can, not really care much about the real challenges confronting those with challenges. You know, when I travelled some years ago, when I travelled to Tasmania and I travelled overseas, when I came into Australia, into the Brisbane International Airport, there were three elderly people that needed a wheelchair. And I think I've discussed this before. There weren't any wheelchairs in the actual terminal, in the airline terminal. And they had to actually... I don't know, they had to race around and get wheelchairs and so forth. And, you know, even going out to the plane on the tarmac, for example, and seeing a stairwell that goes from the tarmac up to the aircraft, probably of 12 steps, how in heaven's name can you expect someone with a disability to be able to, you know, that has a wheelchair to be able to get up there? I mean, come on, you know, it's about time that there's more inclusivity in the world than this. You know, I can remember when I was, and I have my own challenges with flying as well, but for these people that had mobility access, they were struggling on the tarmac to get to the end of the plane. There was no support at all. And I've spoken about this in the book that I've written. I mean, for heaven's sakes, there needs to be amongst all people an awareness of understanding disabilities. You know, it really needs to improve in this regard. I mean, how can people be accommodated in this? I mean, how people that have missing limbs and this sort of a thing, there needs to be a real understanding. In this country, the big problem is that people that have disabilities are expected to just brave up and just put up with it because they're not going to get support. You know, like if you have an anxiety disorder or some other challenge, you know you're not going to get help from within the community, so you don't ask for it. And that's what I found having my own challenges with a disability, you know, that you got to man up or brave up or know that nobody's going to help you. And in the so-called monetary system, it's all about a paycheck more so than actually being concerned about the clients that need the support. And this is what I think the NDIS has to start to recognise. And, you know, I think that to get the services out there, we need to start looking at making those accommodations necessary to be able to include people. And when just looking at the Commonwealth Games incident, I think that's quite appalling that, you know, that this athlete that had to endure this humiliation at the entrance or whatever because they didn't understand, that there wasn't the support of bubble. I mean, it's about time that disability awareness starts to get a really serious makeover in this country. But, you know, if you don't, the wrong people in this country tend to get the awards, don't they? Like the Order of Australia. I mean, who gets the Order of Australia? Well, I mean, he's athlete, I believe, has it. But, you know, ever since knights and dames were removed from Australia, I think, to me, I really think the honour system here is just a really not a good system. Nobody knows what an OAM is. They don't know what the other orders are. And it was watered down by Labor in both accounts, you know. Malcolm Turnbull did the last one. But, you know, I just think that why not reform the honour system as well? Why not allow the citizenry to have a say in the actual redesigning of awards? Thanks very much for watching.